Hello everyone. In my previous two videos already I have explained about U-visible spectrometer, the component of instrumentation and theory and electronic transitions, what is the principle, there's Beer's law, Lambert's law. So in this video I am going to explain some terms involving this UV. So firstly we'll see the formation of absorption bands. So since the energy required for each electronic transition is quantized, the UV visible spectrum is expected to be exhibit a single discrete line corresponding to each electronic transition. So both broad absorption bands are usually absorbed. So designation of absorption band, like we have K band, R band, B band and E band. So UV visible absorption bands may be designated by the type of electronic transition from which they originated. So in case of K bands, these bands originate from pi star transition in compounds having pi star conjugated system. Then R bands are there. In case of R bands, these bands originate from n pi star transitions of single chromophoric group. And in case of B bands, these bands originate from pi star transition in aromatic or hetero aromatic compounds. And E bands, similar to B band, like what we have in B band, it is a aromatic or hetero aromatic compound. So in E bands, similar to B bands, these are characteristic of aromatic and hetero aromatic compound and originated from pi star transition of the this ethylenic bonds present in aromatic ring. Then absorption and intensity shift, like some terms are there like betachromic, hypsochromic, hyperchromic and hypochromic effect. So what is a betachromic shift? So this shift of an absorption maximum to a longer, this shifts the shift of an absorption maximum to a longer wavelength due to the presence of an auxochrome or solvent effect is called as betachromic shift or red shift. The other name which is a red shift. Then we have a hypsochromic shift. This shift of an absorption maxima to a shorter wavelength is called as hypsochromic or blue shift. This is caused by the removal of conjugation or change in the solvent polarity. Then we have a hyperchromic effect. What is a hyperchromic effect? An effect which leads to an increase in absorption intensity to the Emax is called as hyperchromic effect. The introduction of an auxochrome usually causes hyperchromic shift. Then we have hypochromic shift, which is the opposite of hyperchromic, obviously, an effect which leads to a decrease in absorption intensity Emax is called as hypochromic effect. This is caused by the introduction of group which distorts the chromophore. Then some applications of UV visible spectroscopy is like for the detection of functional groups like chromophore. Then detection of conjugation and elucidation of its nature, then the study of extent of conjugation and distinction between conjugated and unconjugated compounds, study of strain, determination of configuration of geometrical isomers, study of tautomerism. Lots of applications are there of UV. Like UV is one of the most used instrument in pharma industry as well as in academic institutions. So from this like two more, they are confirmation of suspected phenols in aromatic amines, study of structural features in different solvents. So you can determine lots of things by using UV. So, thank you.